So thanks for joining me again. Now that we understand the purpose of this content, it's just me taking a practice exam and kind of talking through my own steps and methodologies here. Now it's time to actually get your environment set up if you want to follow along with EvenG. So in this video, what we're going to do is I'm actually going to walk you through how to import the topology and get all of the routers bootstrapped with the IP addresses ready to rock and roll. So that way you can just jump right into the tasks and get started labbing and practicing and having a bunch of fun. Let's go. So the thing that we're going to be teaching right now is how you can get started working with this topology, with this lab. So here we are, I've logged into EvenG and I've got my file. It's a zip file, and that's what we use to import these topologies. Our first step is to look up here, right here in kind of the top little menu section, we see this import button. So we'll give that a click and it asks us which file do we want to import. It's the zip file that we're importing here, knoxlab.zip. I'll click open and it queues the zip file right here at the top of the screen. You have to click the upload button to actually upload it. Now the temptation here is to think that it's still in progress because there's a blue progress bar, but it is up and running right here. So I'll click the Knox lab here and click open. Now if this is your first time firing up this lab, it's not just going to work fresh out of the gate. You can't just turn everything on and hope that it works. Now that we've got this topology imported, let's talk about the quickest way that you can get these routers turned on. I mean, surely you could right click on router 8 here and click start and that would turn it on. But here's the thing, since this is going to be your first time turning these devices on, it's going to be in the initial config dialog state, the factory defaulted state. And we want these devices to come online ready to be worked on within the topology. So what I've done over here on the left-hand side, we can go to the startup config section and we can actually turn startup configs on so that way they boot up with this particular startup config. Let's pick on router 8 for a second here and turn router 8 on. If you actually click on router 8, you can see here's a text file basically, and I see some edits I need to make already. Look at that. There we go. Clean up that stuff right there. This is what it's going to boot with. And you can see there's really nothing out of the ordinary here. This is just going to be the defaulted IP address. The exception to this is going to be what's going to be in the SD access section with our border and edge nodes. Those will have a much more robust config that it'll be importing. But in this case, what we've got here is I've now turned on router 8 to be the startup config. Click save just to make sure it's all good here. And all I have to do now is turn router 8 on. We can watch it come to life, and it should come to life with a host name and the IP addresses exactly as we'd expect. So we'll give it a second to boot up and check on it when it's done. That's about all the time it takes to get booted up here. Now if I press enter, we can see the host name is set to R8. I can give it a show IP interface brief. And the big thing I want you to notice is that the method that it acquired these IP addresses was TFTP. So at this point, what I want to do is I want to give this a copy, run start. That way it copies the config into NVRAM. And now the next time that I turn this device on, it'll be able to boot straight up from this regardless of the startup config. The next thing I want to show you is what to do in the event that maybe you've hosed the lab too much or you want to start over from scratch. Let's keep picking on router 8 here. What we can do is we can right click on it and click wipe. We'll say yes to this, and it takes a second to actually wipe out the actual configuration and shut the device down. So now that it's shut down, when we go back to startup configs, you want to make sure that it's turned back on and it'll start up the next time with this running config right here. So this is going to be a great way for you if you're working through the lab and you want to start over on a particular device or set of devices, you can right click on it, choose wipe, and then turn it back on for the startup config. Now, another thing that's been pointed out to me is that when you import this for the first time, there is a chance that your images may default to the wrong image. For instance, when we look at the routers, I'm going to pick on router 12 here. If we click on edit, we can see right here it's defaulting to my layer 3 Linux image. But some people have also experienced that when it comes to the switches, it will also default to the layer 3 router image. So before you boot up the switches for the first time, you want to right click on the switches, choose edit, and make sure it's defaulting to the layer 2 image. This is going to be particularly useful for you when you start the layer 2 task and we have to edit these switches, or over here in the bright pink where we need to work on the SD access switches. Now again, these SD access switches will have full-blown configs already attached to them. So keep all that in mind before you fire up the switches for the first time that you may have to change the image that it's using. You know, this is a pretty large topology And if you turn all of these things on at once and you don't have your computer's not quite strong enough, it may be under some load. So right here on the left-hand side, you'll want to use status and just check on what is the status of my computer, what's my CPU usage, what's my memory usage. Mine is very high right now because I actually have a copy of this lab with every node turned on at this point. So, you know, with 50-odd nodes and the QEMU nodes and the Docker nodes here, it's still only using 6% CPU, but my memory usage is high. So depending on your machine, you'll want to keep tabs on how many nodes you have running and any stress that it's under because of that. The other things that I wanted to show you here are, of course, the lab tasks themselves. This is what you came here for. So here are the 11 lab tasks, and unfortunately, because of the way task management works, there's no way I can sort these in the correct order. I kind of just created them in this order, and that's how they show up. So the order that we're going to be going through here in this particular lab, you start with Internet Network. That's here in the third on the list. Then you go to MPLS Network. That's the first one on the list. Then we do the Layer 2 tasks. Then we do customer one sites, then we do customer two sites, then we do MPLS layer 3 VPN, then we do multicast, then DMVPN. Then these last three, they can kind of come really at any order that you want. I plan on releasing them in the order of SD access, SD-WAN, and then automation. So that sets up the basics of how to get started with this lab.